गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर दर्शना मौर्य, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर नासिक। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट कल्टिवेशन ऑफ टी। सो द बोटेनिकल नेम ऑफ टी इज कैमिलिया सिनेंसिस अंडर द फैमिली कैमिलियांसी ऑर्थियासी। क्रोमोजोम नंबर इज 2N=30। इट इज बीवरेज क्रॉप। एज अ यूजेस ऑफ टी इज टी कंटेन्स अल्कोलाइड कॉल्ड एज थीम 2-5%, which is caffeineous alkaloids, relieving body fatigue. However, excessive drinking is harmful to our digestive system. Some of the polyphenols are present in a tea. It reduces the blood cholesterol and cures hepatitis, hypertension, stone formation, etc. Heart attack is due to the cholesterol and triglycerides, which is saturated fatty acids. Some of the medicinal properties of teas in black tea is fully fermented tea, is anti-ulceric and carcinogenic in nature. Resuscitation of tea is in India is first is UPASI, United Planters Association of Southern India, Tea Research Institute, Nirar, Tamil Nadu. Then Tea Experiment Station, Toklai, Jorhat, Assam. And Tea Board is located at Kolkata. Climatic requirement for tea is for tea cultivation, the optimum mean maximum temperature is 29.5 degrees Celsius and minimum temperature is 13 degrees Celsius, South India versus North India. Tea is cultivated on hilly tract around 1000 meter and above the temperature is relatively low here, where as in North India, the temperature is high during summer on the plains, which unfavorable for high tea productivity and good stand of shade trees is therefore grown for the optimizing productivity. Then altitude, it ranges from the sea level up to 2460 meters above the mean sea level. In North India, tea plantation are located in the plains, while in South India, tea is cultivated in hilly terrains. China tea is grown on higher altitudes. So the tea is cultivated in South India and also in the North India. Rainfall requirement for tea cultivation, well distributed rainfall ranging between 125 to 750 centimeter. In northeastern India, tea receives copious rainfall, 150 to 500 centimeter. However, the distribution is most uneven. The annual rainfall in South India tea growing areas varies between 90 to 800 centimeter. Day length. Critical day length for vegetative growth, 10.5 hours. It varies from 9.4 to 15 hours in North India, whereas the tea growing in areas lies between 24 north and 28 degree latitude. Day length varies from 10 to 13 hours during different season. Then winter. November to March, shorter day length, vegetative growth and almost ceases. However, this is compensated during July to September, summer season, and long conducive to growth vegetative. Then, relative humidity in North India high, more than 60% throughout the year, and South India falls as low as 15% in February to March. Frost causes adverse effect on tea bushes, especially in the ravines. Soil requirement for tea. For the tea cultivation required wide range of soil, acidic in reaction. In Northeast India, the soil under tea range from lightest of sand to stiffest of clays and include silt sand loam and even peat soil. It prefers a soil rich in organic matter with well-drained situation. It grows not only on hill slopes but also on low-lying flatlands. As in some areas of North India, provided the soil is well-drained, some of the finest plantation in Assam are found on level ground. In Darjeeling, where the agroclimatic conditions are similar to those in the hilly tracts of Western Ghats and also Nilgiri Hills in South India, tea is cultivated on hilly slopes. Calcifuge is nature of tea. Tea is a calcifuge and an aluminium accumulator. Performance of tea in soil with higher calcium is not satisfactory. It grows on soil which are generally rich in iron and manganese. Then varieties of tea. There are different types of varieties actually clone. So the first is Jayaram Upasi 2. The features of these varieties are an average yielding clone, suitable for high elevation, all elevation, and tolerant to drought and wind. Then Upasi 3 Sundaram variety, very high yielding and quality clone. Upasi 6 Brookland fares well at mid and higher elevation. Then Golconda Upasi 8 high yielding, suitable for all elevation. Upasi 9 Athreya, it is high yielding and fairly tolerant to drought, withstand slightly high pH. Upasi 10 Pandian, hardy clone, resistant to drought and wind, suitable for high elevation. Then Upasi 14 Singara, quality clone, suitable for high elevation. Upasi 17 then TRI T-Research 24 Sri Lanka, a high yielding clone, and TRI T-Research Institute 2015 Sri Lanka, average yielding and hardy clone. Planting material and plant propagation in tea. Tea is commercially propagated through cuttings. Seed is a convenient is to use as a planting material in tea. Till today it is generally propagated from the seed, but during recent years to use of high yielding clonal material, hence vegetative propagation. Tea is outbreeding and will not produce true seeds because of sterility. Genetically it is heterogeneous for the potential yield, disease resistant and manufacturing quality. Vegetative propagation, there are different types of propagation methods can be adopted in a tea. In that one, first is budding, then grafting on rootstock, layering, and by cutting. Popular method of vegetative propagation is cutting. Vegetative propagation by budding, grafting, and layering is too laborious to adopt. Then grafting. It is practiced for successful propagation of high yielding drought susceptible clone used as a scion on drought hardy clones as a root stock. Scion cultivar is a susceptible drought susceptible scion clone and drought hardy resistant to as a root stock. We can use in a grafting. In South India, nursery graft have been made using high yielding clones such as Upasi 3, 8, 17 as a scion and drought hardy clones Upasi 2, 6, 9, 10 and 24. Then ATK 1, SA 6 and TRI 20, 25 as a rootstock. So there is in grafting the different different scion and rootstock are compatible with each other according to the drought conditions. In a view of grafting success survival, graft vigor of composite plants and yield of the following graft combination have been recommended for commercial exploitation in South India. Vegetative propagation by cutting. Commercial method of propagation is through single node cutting. Semi hardwood cutting is preferred method. elite clones should be selected with desirable characters like yield, quality and quick recovery, so that commercially tea is propagated by means of cuttings. Feature of mother bush: compactness, number of stem per unit area should be high and should be uniformly distributed. Then individual stem should be thick and uniform. Bushes should have early filling tendency. Bushes should have a lateral spreading habit, and main stem and primary branches should have upright growth after pruning. Density of locking point units should be high. Then flushes leaves should have a pubescence. Then bushes should be resistant to blister, blight and free from other pests, and it should be drought tolerant. High yield and yield per unit area of plucking table should be high. Flowering tendency: select bushes should not have a flowering tendency. Selection of site and establishing a tea plantation. New estate establishment: clearing of forest growth by removing all unwanted plants, leaving only permanent trees, shade trees. Take appropriate step to prevent soil erosion. General burning is not advocated as it make the soil alkaline, reduces the soil fertility, and it is necessary burning is done away from the planting site. Tea bushes will having an economical life of over 40 years. While selecting site, following precaution should be taken. Slopy and hilly terrain or jungles. Take adequate soil conservation measures to protect the soil erosion and also moisture conservation. Soil acidic with adequate depth, good drainage, temporary shade has to be provided for young developed plants. So then time of planting: North India winter season with low rainfall but with plenty of mist of is desirable. October November is time of planting in North India. In South India, May and June. Rainy season. Planting operation: pit size 40 cm diameter, 60 cm depth. Then pits or the pits of 30 by 35 depth, and if land is not good, 45 by 45 by 45 depth and 60 by 60 by 60 depth. Plant spacing: a plant population of tea bushes varies from 14 to 18,000 per hectare. Higher plant population showed adverse effect after 4 to 5 years. The spacing varies region to region and variety to variety. 1.5 by 1.5 meter, 1.5 by 0.75 meter. It accommodates about 14,000 plants per hectare. As a close spacing gives quick covering. Then 1.2 to 0.75 meter. Then 1.2 by 0.60 meter accommodates more than 60,000 plants per hectare. Remaining part we will see in the next videos. Thank you.